greetings to you all from wherever you are tuning in today's service. I am glad that you are able to join. This is St. Andrew's Church Air. Today is the day of our Lord, the ninth day of August 2020. David says, I am glad when they say to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Our call to worship is taken from Psalm 85 and reading from verse 8. I will listen to what God the Lord says. He promises peace to his people, his faithful servants. But let them not turn to folly. Surely, his salvation is near those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Love and faithfulness meet together. Righteousness and peace kiss each other. Faithfulness springs forth from the earth, and righteousness looks down from heaven. The Lord will indeed give what is good, and our land will yield its harvest. Righteousness goes before him and prepares the way for his steps. Let us turn our hearts to God in prayer. Let us pray. You are indeed mighty in power, O God. You raised up the mountains and scooped out the ocean depths. You set the stars in their motion and brought forth life on this earth. You preside over the seasons of the year and the seasons of our lives. Yet you are also a God of love and care, who mourns our unresponsiveness and agonizes over the suffering of the smallest child in the remotest village of the world. We have not loved you, O God, as you have loved us. We have been like children who accepted love without knowing its cost. Forgive us, we pray, for every act of betrayal, every failure to be kind, every gratification of self, and every blindness to the needs of others. Come and dwell in us with your spirit of generosity, that we may bless the world with what you have given us, for your name's sake. Fill us now with your spirit, that we may see life as it really is, and not as our culture has told us it is. Help us to follow life and ministry of Jesus in our own lives, that we may know with him the joy and power of the resurrection. Instruct our hearts in tenderness and our souls in courage, that we may serve you well today and all our lives through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Fight with us still, and with all reading this morning comes from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 14, reading from verse 22. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone, but the boat was already a considerable distance from the shore, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking in the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid." "Lord, is it you?" Peter replied. "Tell me to come to you on the waves." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they had climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Amen, and thanks be to God for this reading of his word.
Let us prepare our hearts to hear the word of God. Jesus says, "Don't be afraid, it is I." Let us pray. Loving God, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you. Speak to us with accent clear and still, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our theme for today is when faced with storm and doubt. It is a continuation of the message of last Sunday, flowing from Matthew chapter 14, after Jesus has fed the crowd. He sent his disciples to the other side of the lake, and they were faced with storm and wave, tossed here and there. They were afraid. And I want to ask us this morning, who do we look to for help when we seem to be alone and in total darkness as life tosses us about? Let us remember and understand that in devastating situations, the one who loves us well will come to our rescue. Let us look at the story of a small boat in a stormy sea, as read to us from Matthew chapter 14 and from verse 22. Jesus told his disciples, "Go before me to the other side of the lake." After which he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. Sometimes it seems as if he sends us forth alone. But we should remember that God is everywhere and at all times. We are never alone. When he does send us, it is because he has a special miracle planned for us. When the crowd saw the miracle Jesus performed, they wanted to make Jesus an earthly king. Beloved listener, hear this. When seduced by worldly promotion, that is not in the plan of God for you. All you have to do is to find a solitary place all alone for yourself for prayer. We should always ask heaven to keep us from the arrogance that leads us away from the will of God. From verse 24, we read that the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by here and there by the wave. The disciples were where Jesus has wanted them to be, but they seem to be in trouble. Sometimes when we believe with our whole hearts that we are where God wants us to be, things seem to go wrong. We doubt our calling. Sometimes Jesus sends us to sea, even though he knows a storm is coming. We face winds of false doctrine, waves of temptation, and storms of mistreatment. Jesus is not trying to hurt us in any way, but he wants us to understand the dynamics and the principle of walking in faith and not by sight. Sometimes in Christian life, Jesus allows us to go through most of the night before he comes to us. And when he does come, he may come in the form of a miracle, a supernatural event that is beyond natural explanation, like walking on the water. God often chooses to intervene just before we lose hope. Now, when the disciples saw Jesus walking on the sea, they were terrified, they were afraid, saying, "It is a ghost." Jesus does not come to terrify us or to make us scared, to scare us in any form. No, but he comes to us always to rescue us and to give us a hope and to give our lives meaning. Noticing that his disciples were afraid, immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Do not be afraid." Beloved, I hear Jesus saying to you this morning, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid. In the midst of stormy wind and waves, Jesus spoke. He must have been close to the disciples because he is always near us. The boat is an ancient Christian symbol of disciples tossed to and fro with trials of faith, mistreatments, temptations. Yet Jesus calms the storm and provides safety. In church architecture, the center of the church is the nave, meaning a ship. As Jesus comes to our boat and carries us through, he leads us to safety harbor. He leads us to eternity in the bliss of God. Peter asks Jesus to let him come and walk on the water. What a curiosity. And Jesus said to him, "Come." And when Peter had come out of the boat, he walked on the water to meet the master. Some of us are bold like Peter, ready to take the first quick step towards Jesus. Some of us are like that. There is an example of what someone can accomplish with Christ, with God's help, in their initial rush of faith and desire to be with Jesus. Studies have shown that all of people who rush forward at modern forms of evangelistic rallies, only about 15% join a church and stay. Spontaneity is good. Perseverance is better. After Peter's impulsiveness and Jesus granting his request to walk on the water, he quickly began to doubt. He saw what the wind was doing. He looked away from the master and he was afraid because he moved his focus out of Jesus to the storm, and he began to sink. Beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, "Lord, save me." There is often a conflict between sight and faith. Faith is the evidence of things not seen, the assurance of things that are hoped for. Moments like this come to us all in different times and places. We begin to sink in life's stormy waters and realize that we have more zeal than we have faith. We have had our eyes on our turbulent circumstances and not on Jesus Christ. Then we cry out, "Lord, save, save me." And Jesus is always ready to save, always ready to deliver, always ready to take us in his arms. Jesus stretched out his hand to catch him and said to him, "O ye of little faith, why did you doubt?" Is that what Jesus is saying to you? Why are you doubting? Why can't you trust and obey? And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. Stepping out of the boat and walking on water begins with a prayer of request, followed by an invitation from Jesus to come. Then as Peter, we cry, "Truly, you are the Son of God. You are the Son of God." Understand that God is in control of every situation. There is no distraction from which he cannot deliver you and I. No worry too great for him to overcome. So whether it is lack of finances, or your health is threatened, your job is at risk, or you face family stresses, you can conquer doubt by trusting completely in God to guide you. Sometimes we seem to be all alone at night in a storm at the sea, when we are tossed by waves of temptation and doubt. Jesus comes to us in the midst of a dark night. He calms the water, the storm, and he says, "Peace, be still." And I speak to every storm of your life, every wind that has been tossing you here and there, peace be still in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we give thanks to you because you are the God of the seas, the land, heaven, and the earth. There is nothing impossible with you. Help us as we navigate this storm of life and bring us to a safe harbor to the glory and praise of your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sail the sea of faith, find out before too long. How quickly blue skies can grow dark and gentle winds grow strong. And suddenly fear is like a white water pounding on your soul. But still we sail on, knowing that our Lord in control. Sometimes he calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. He can settle any sea, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close, lets the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child. He has a reason for each trial that we pass through in life. And though we're shaken, cannot be pulled apart from Christ. No matter how the driving rain beats down on those who hold faith, a heart of trust will always be a quiet, peaceful place. Sometimes he calms the storm with a whisper, peace be still. He can settle see, but it doesn't mean he will. Sometimes he holds us close as the wind and waves go wild. Sometimes he calms the storm, and other times he calms his child.
Let us bring our prayer of thanksgiving and supplication for others before God. Let us pray. Eternal and loving God, who watches over us with endless love and care, we thank you for the journey of life and each of its stages. It is all a rainbow of splendor and excitement, a pilgrimage of learning and experience. We give thanks to you for every stage of it. And we ask that you help us to walk in it always with a sense of your presence, of never being alone, of living forever under grace. Dear loving God, as schools are set to reopen, we bring before you school children and their teachers. Watch over them and protect them. Make the teaching and learning environment a safe place for them all. And as churches reopen their doors for public worship, including our own church, make it a safe place as we worship and commune with you, O God, and with each other. Take away fear and doubt from each of us, and may the assurance of your presence and power bring courage to each of us. Heal others who are sick. Strengthen the weak and comfort those who mourn. Provide shelter to the homeless and bring peace in our world. Let the talents and wisdom and love you have given us find rich expression in our work and play and daily relationships. Show us how to give ourselves to others until we have overcome the deficiencies in ourselves. Let goodness, mercy, and peace attend us all and bring us at last into the presence of your saints and angels and of our Lord Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me, and I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love forever. Set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love. Foolishness, I know, but when the world has seen the light, they will dance with joy like we're dancing now. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love forever. I can sing.
Thank you for joining us in today's service. I trust you have been blessed with the Word of God. And I want to remind you again that you are not alone. God is always with you. When you face the storm of life, the trials of life, always use the quarter second prayer like Peter, "Save, Lord," and He will never disappoint you. I send you forth with assurance that God is with you. Go with the love and peace of God. May the presence of God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit always go with you, now and forever. Amen. I want to remind you that all is done and the service is set to happen live again in the church sanctuary. As you can, I invite you to worship with us in the church sanctuary of St. Andrew's Air. Your safety is our priority, and we have put all things in place to keep you safe. If you wish to join us next Sunday as we worship in the church sanctuary, go to our Facebook page or our YouTube handle. Let us know your plan to join us in the service as we will guide you through. God helping us, the storm is over, the battle is over, and victory is yours. Glory to God. See you in Jesus' name. Amen.